Namaste. I'm Dr. Nischal, practicing as a consultant dermatologist at Nirmal Skin and Hair Clinic, Vijayanagar, Bengaluru. Dyshidrotic eczema is an endogenous eczema, means it's an allergy-like reaction which is happening not because from something external. It is an allergy reaction which is happening from within. See, many times what happens is we react to pollens, we react to dust, we react to some other cosmetics. But here the reaction is more the immune system, which is already active, it is hyperreactive. So it starts recognizing and fighting against its own body molecules. So this tendency in general is called as atopy. Atopy is nothing but an increased immune status where the immunity is hyperreacting. Means, to give an example, see, children when they are playing, it's actually nice to see. But when they are very active, it becomes difficult to control them. See, that is what is atopy. So here the immune system is overtly reacting to the normal antigens, and these molecules to which it is reacting is mostly internal. This tendency can start as early as 6 months to any age group. So even at 60, 70 years, this eczema can happen. So what happens in this eczema? So here the main focus is palms and soles. So people develop a lot of itching, small bubbles and rashes, which are usually along the sides of the fingers and along the sides of the palms. So this area is most commonly involved. And here they develop small rashes, small blisters. Here, since the skin is thick, the blisters are not so easily ruptured. Okay, so we have a lot of deep seated vesicles. They look like sago grains. And these are very itchy. People keep rubbing their hands. And these rashes or the vesicles or the fluid filled blisters, when they dry, they become scaly. So naturally people can present with a rash, they can develop small blisters, there can be oozing when the blisters rupture, or there can be dried skin which is peeling off, and commonly it involves palms and soles. Any atopy or immunity related reactions, they fluctuate with lot of lifestyle changes. Means whenever there is a lot of stress, when the sleep is not proper, in those situations, the immunity fluctuates. At that time, eczema increases. Second aspect is whenever we fall ill, any medical illness, it can be a common cold, cough, or it can be a serious infections like typhoid. Any infection alters the immune status. So at that time, again, the eczema increases. Third thing is exposure to a lot of perfumes and cosmetics and creams which have a lot of preservatives. These things can also increase eczema reaction. So the dyshidrotic eczema increases with this. See, that is the reason why we ask, like when people have a dry skin and they have a skin rash, we ask them to use a dermatologically tested or a dermatologically safe moisturizer. We ask people to avoid regular cosmetic brand moisturizers, because these regular cosmetic brand moisturizers have a lot of feel good factor, and that is in the form of fragrance or something like a color. Those chemicals can cross-react with eczema. So that is why when you have an eczema reaction, you can't use a regular moisturizer, a cosmetic moisturizer. And then comes food. In food, the main thing is a lot of preservative containing food should be avoided, because these things can increase eczema reaction. Like for example, your packed food. So it can be biscuits, it can be chocolates, it can be any other packed food, because naturally, for the food to be preserved, they use a lot of chemicals which can cross-react with this. Second aspect is it's also good to avoid chocolates, because they are rich in nickel, and nickel is also known to give a lot of allergy reactions. Nuts and also green leafy vegetables also have nickel in a good proportion. So see if when you consume these ingredients, these fruits or vegetables or these food items, if the itching or the blisters increase, please avoid them. Also, you can get an allergy test done to check this. So this is dyshidrotic eczema. So this is how the eczema happens. It can happen across all age groups. It involves palms and soles. You can present with the itching, blisters and scaling. And how do we prevent this? As I told you, any eczema reaction is a lifestyle change. So eat well, sleep well, exercise well. These are the three main basic principles which control our immunity as well as our hormones. So this has to be done. Daily 1 hour of exercise, 6 to 7 hours of sleep and good food. They help you to control eczema reactions. Then comes taking care of the dryness. So apply liberally a lot of moisturizers. You can also use coconut oil, or the next best oil for the skin is sunflower oil. These things can be applied. Whenever the skin is soft and hydrated, the itching is less. The inflammation starts coming under control faster. Then the specific treatment is, we have to reduce the hyperactive immunity. For that, we commonly use topical steroids, but the steroid cream should not be used without consulting your dermatologist. Whenever the creams have to be given for a longer duration, we do use steroid sparing creams, which are safer for a longer duration. So these creams have to be started in consultation with a dermatologist. When the eczema reactions are more, we put on systemic medications, internal medications, which are given for a few weeks to control the reaction. This way, we can definitely treat and control dyshidrotic eczema.